है गेट लेवल लॉजिक ऑफ सीमॉस, गेट लेवल लॉजिक ऑफ सीमॉस. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू दिस वी हैव टू नो द लॉजिक फैमिलीज. सो लॉजिक फैमिलीज आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स विच आर RTL logic, resistor transistor logic, and DCTL logic, direct coupled transistor logic, transistor transistor logic, and also we have emitter coupled logic. And similarly, so many types of logic families we have, and also we have CMOS logic, right? So by these all logic families we have, so those having the high propagation delay time, more power dissipation, EBM more, and it will occupy some more space for the fabrication of the ICs. So because of that, for VLSI technology to overcome all the drawbacks, whatever that area, that means the space will be occupied less and the propagation delay time will be less. So because of that, we are using the CMOS logic family for the ICs of VLSI technology. So in the VLSI technologies, we are using the VLSI technology, the logic families as CMOS logic family. So in that, first we have to go how the gate levels, gates will be. We have a logic gate, so many logic gates we have. So what are the logic gates we have here? It is inverter, that is simply NOT gate, inverter that is simply NOT gate, and AND gate, OR gate, and NAND, NOR. These all are the logic basic gates we have. So we can implement these all basic gates by using the CMOS logic in a gate level logic of a CMOS. So first I will explain that inverter. So already you know that the CMOS inverter. So first we go to the CMOS inverter. So what is an inverter? So inverter having the only one input. So first we go to the CMOS inverter. So inverter. So first we have to go to the inverter. Inverter is a NOT gate. It is a symbol of the inverter. So it has only one input. So input will be a 1 and only an output. If input is 0, output will become 1. If input is 1, output will become a 0. So that's the truth table of your NOT gate. Simple inverter. So now we have to implement this NOT function by using the logic as CMOS logic. So CMOS, in the sense, we have to use the combination of P and N MOS. So P MOSFET also we have, and N MOSFET also we have to use. See, P MOS symbol is this one, and N MOS symbol is here. So P MOS, we have to keep a bubble at the input, and N MOS, there is no bubble at the input. So this is your P MOS. So P MOS, I am taking here, it is M1, and this is your N MOS, I am taking it as an input. So P MOS, your VDD is connected, the power supply, this is gate, source and drain, and this is a gate, and this is your source, and this is your drain. So this is your ground, and this is input terminal, and source to drain terminal we are having the output. This is a simple structure of a CMOS inverter. So this is a simple schematic diagram of a CMOS inverter circuit. So here we have a one PMOS circuit and one NMOS circuit. So before going to the working of this, we have to know when the PMOS will be connected and the NMOS will be connected. So if we are applying, here it is a digital logic we are taking, so for the digital case I am taking, if input logic, if logic is, if logic is 0, this PMOS will be connected, CMOS will be unstable. And if the logic will be a 1, if the logic will be a 1, NMOS will be on. So that we have to remember for the working of this CMOS inverter. Simple, PMOS, when we are applying the logic 0, it will be connected. For NMOS, we are applying the logic 1, then only it will be connected. So here logic 0 and logic high levels will be a different for the CMOS technologies. It may be 0, 0 to 2.5 like that, it having a different values. So for the first, we have what is the input case here, truth table we have. So first input case, first case 1 we will go. So for the case 1, so if Vin is 0. So I am taking the logic 0, not the 0 volts here, logic 0. For the logic 0, how much the voltage that will be needed, that we have to apply. So for the logic 0, what happens here? PMOS. M1 will be connected. And M2 will be off state. Right? So M1 is a PMOS, so this will be in on state, and NMOS will be in off state. So what is the equivalent circuit we have to draw? So now equivalent circuit of that case, equivalent circuit for the case 1, if Vin is logic 0. So what we have here, VDD, here this is a PMOS and M2 will be in a on state. So what is the equivalent circuit for this case? Here we are finding. So equivalent circuit of this case is, so here VDD and this is your M1 and this is your M2. PMOS is M1, so M1 will be in a off state and M2 will be in a on state. So as this will be in a on state, here what happens here? This VDD is not at all connected to your output terminal. So directly this output will be connected to ground. So ground in the sense, what is your output will be approximately a ground potential, that will be a zero. So logic zero. So we are getting a input as a logic 1, output as a logic 0. So that means simple inverter. So this circuit will be simple CMOS inverter circuit. Right? See, this is a NOT gate we have implemented by using the CMOS logic. So that you have to verify. The truth table we have, input will be a 0, only single input it has. So input will be a 0, output will become a 1. Here how many gates we are using? Only 2 log gates we are using. 1 PMOS FET and 1 NMOS FET. Simple designing, and it will be having a only 1 input and 1 output. But whereas coming to the next logic, so if you are going to the NAND logic or NOR logic, so we will go to that the next case. So for that we have a 2 inputs. So for the 2 inputs we have 2, 4 and 2, 4. So 4 logic gate, 4 combinations we have, so 4 basic MOSFETs will be used. So next second one I am going to the CMOS NOR gate. CMOS or NAND gate. CMOS NAND logic, right? So NAND logic here, so we have to use 4 total MOSFETs, 2 PMOSFETs will be required and 2 NMOSFETs will be required, okay? So those we have, so here PMOSFETs will be connected in parallel combination. Here for the product term, so for the product term, PMOSFETs will be connected in a parallel and some terms PMOSFETs will be connected in a series. So now we are NAND, it is a product term, A into B bar. So that's why we are using a parallel combination. So here VDD we have and 2 PMOSFETs I already told. These 2 will be connected in a parallel, right? So these 2 will be connected in a parallel. This is here A. Similarly, here we have this next combination, N MOSFETs. These N MOSFETs will be connected in a series. So here this A, similar A will be connected here. And this is B, so the same B will be connected to this one. Okay, so this is here A, where it is a dot, but dot indicating there is a connection. If there is a no dot, then there is no interconnection between the those two points. So at the common between these two terminals, we are taking the output. So here it is the input, this is B in 1 way, and this is also B in 2. This is 1 and this is 2. 2 inputs will be required. So A and B, and this output will be a single output. So here I am notated as it is Y for the truth table. And here this will be a PMOS, and this is also be a PMOS, and this is NMOS, and this is also NMOS. So I am taking this notation as a M1, this is M2, and this is here M3, and this is here MOSFET 4. Right? So before going to the working here, this will be a ground and a DSS. So before going to the working of this, just we have to know the truth table of a NAND logic. So what is the NAND symbol is this one, NAND gate is this one, right? It has a 2 inputs, A, B and Y. So what is the truth table of this NAND gate? So if you are going to the truth table of this NAND gate, A, B and Y, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So what is the Y output for this NAND gate is complementary of A AND gate. So for AND gate, if any one of the input is 0, output is 0. Similarly, the NAND gate, the complementary of your AND, so if any one of the input is 0, applying the logic 1, then only there will become a hot conduction state. So N3 and N4 are in hot state. So these two states we have, that will be M1, M2 are non-state, M1, M2, these two P MOSFETs will be non-state, M3, M4 are in hot state. Now you have to draw the equivalent circuit. What is the equivalent circuit? You have to draw depending on the conduction. So if it is in on, open circuit, if it is in off, closed circuit. Right? So now here it is M1, M2, and here we are finding the output, and this here we have M3 and M4. Right? So this will be connected to ground. So here this is VDD, supply voltage. So this is here M1, M2, M3 and M4. So now what happens? M1 and M2 are in on state, conduction state, so it will be short circuit. Both are in conduction state. But this will be in off state. M3 and M4 are in off state. So what happens here? Two MOSFETs, M1 and M2 are in on state. Total, whatever the VDD we have, so that VDD is going to flow through the output, not to the ground. Why? Because M3 and M4 are in not conduction state. So M1 and M2 are in a conduction state. Maximum output will be flows to the VDD. So into your output. So output is approximately VDD. So what is your output level is logic high. So here we have a truth table, then what happens here? 0, 0 case, first case, what is your output will be a high number. So similarly for the case 2 and case 3 also, if you observe, case 2 and case 3, if any one of the input is in high, 0 level. So here A may be a 0 or B may be a 0. Any one of the input may be a 0, then what happens? Any one of the P MOSFET will be conducts. Right? So if any one of the input will become a logic 0, one of the M1 M2 will be conduct. So what happens if any one of the M, if suppose M1 is in off state, M2 is in conduction state, then also the supply is connected to your output. So directly maximum output will be flows to your VDD. So that output will be a VDD become a high level. So what happens that any one of the case, if any one of the A may be a 0 or maybe B is 0, so one will be a conduct. So because of that, always the output will become a 0. But when this output will become a 5. But when it will become 0, when both of P MOSFETs, for example here, when both the P MOSFETs here, these two MOSFETs will be in a half state, then only this output will become a low. When these two will become non-conduction state, so if suppose, the case 4 we have, if suppose A is 1 and B is 1, so the last case we have that A is 1 and B is 1 case, then what happens? M1, M2 will become off, right? So why? Because these two are P MOSFETs. And M3 and M4 are to become on state. So simply here, what happens? The reversal operation we are getting, M3, M4 will be conduction state, it will be a short circuited, and M1 and M2 are in off state. So off state in the sense the supply is not at all connected to your output. So supply is not at all connected to your output. So where this output is connected here, this terminal to the ground only it will be connected. So output will be a low level, and approximately it will be a ground potential we have. So that ground potential indicates a logic as low level. So because of that, for all the combinations we are taking, if any one of the input is 0, that P MOSFET will be conducting, so output will become a on, high level. But whereas coming to the 1-1 case, two P MOSFETs will be in off state, the supply is not at all connected, your output will be connected to the ground, so your output will be a 0. So like that we have a CMOS NAND. Similarly, if you want to design a AND gate, CMOS AND gate if you want, what is this? This is a NAND, is complement of AND, right? So here I have a NAND.